cares? That's his face! Around the outside of Woodcombe! You can't do that!
No! They're side by side! Unbelievable! Rings is off the circuit almost!
And look at Vinales! Vinales coming right back into contention! Through Stoke for the final time! Up towards Magnussen Beckett! It's Marquez from Rings! How on earth did Rings have the bravery and the courage to ride around the outside of Marquez through Woodcombe? I've never seen that happen before!
Vinales is in contention here. Around Magnussen Beckett we go on the final lap here in the British Grand Prix. Who wins? Honda, Suzuki or Yamaha? Marquez doing everything he can to defend now.
Who's got the drive then down the hangar straight? Marquez has got the advantage. Alex Rins is not close enough to attack into Stoke corner. Marquez gets it sideways on the braking zone. He's in deep, but he'll pull it down to the apex. It's still Marc Marquez, almost half the way round this final lap of the British Grand Prix. Rins not close enough to strike at Vale.
Back wheel in the air from Marc Marquez as he breaks deep down into Vale corner turns 8 and 9. Vinales trying to reach and touch these guys, but it's not happening. We're running out of time here for Rins to make a move.
Through club for the final time, Marquez, Rins and Vinales up into Abbey, coming up to Aintree and the loop where Alex Rins took the lead on the last lap. Is he going to be close enough? This is where he's been brilliant coming into Village Corner. Marquez runs that tight defensive line. Alex Rins is not going to be close enough now to pounce.
We go left into the loop and there's a sweeping line coming again from Alex Rins. Is he going to try the same again? Marquez says, no, you don't. Marquez, he's got to try and get close enough for the slipstream.
Clever by Marquez. He just blocked him, parked that Honda in the middle of the corner. He knew that Rins could sweep underneath him. Marquez then into Brooklands for the final time. Has he got the job done? He's so hard on that front end. Rins is trying everything to get the Suzuki into contention. They come into Loughfield. Surely Rins is not going to try and ride around the outside of Marquez again into Woodcote. One corner to go, Marquez versus Rins.
Here we go then, around the final corner. Rins is going to have another look. Surely not around the
outside. He's got the drive.
He's done it.
He's done it. Unbelievable.
He's done it. Rins has poached it. Unbelievable.
Final lap now with Ben Spies leading from Stoner. Dovizioso has settled for third. Has Stoner, is he going to have to settle for second place?
I think he may. I think it's just a question if Ben Spies can keep this sort of pace up in these conditions. Again, he looks behind him. Number 11, the American, the Texan, the former World Superbike champion. He won his first Grand Prix in quite similar conditions at Assen in Holland earlier this season. He's missed the last two races. He's back with a bang. Is Ben Spies going to win his second Grand Prix?
Oh, there's still a little bit to go on this final lap. Abraham's got through on Crutchlow and Pedrosa now. So Abraham, through that last split, goes up into fourth place. Ben Spies could have this one in the bag, depending on if Stoner can do anything around this long left-hander, the final corner on the circuit, which tightens up for turn 14. Crutchlow back in front. No, Abraham's down. Crutchlow could be about to take fourth place in this race. And Danny Pedrosa in fifth. Who's going to win it, though?
Through turn 14 they come, the very last bend of the new season. And Casey Stoner tries to put up alongside Ben Spies.
Oh, it could be Stoner! It's Stoner who wins coming out of the final corner. I do not believe it.
Oh, Casey Stoner pulls it out of the bag at the very last meter of the race. Andre Dovizioso third, Cal Crutchlow four, Danny Pedrosa five. What a race!
The start and finish line now. One lap to go. Roberts comes under pressure from Rossi. Rossi pulls alongside him. Elias is also there. And Elias is an absolute demon of late braking. And it's Elias has taken the lead. Tony Elias has taken the lead. Roberts is alongside him. Rossi has been relegated to third place. Yep. Roberts now has relegated to third because Rossi's moved back into second.
We thought this race had lost it after the demise.
Let's look at this again. Look at Tony Lewis. Where has he come from?
Oh, that was so close to me. Oh, what a desperate, determined move that was. Now, what can Rossi do?
Rossi still in second place. Tony Lewis leads the way. Kenny Roberts, Cuny in third. Colin Edwards not quite close enough, but don't rule him out in fourth place. Rossi's going to have one big go. You can absolutely guarantee it. But Elias is riding the race of his life.
Going into the chicane, Nick, what do you reckon?
Not sure. I'm really not sure. Elias, so close to win this one. Up through the right hand, and now they're coming up to 8, 9, and 10. And there goes Rossi, absolutely right. Rossi's
Valentino Rossi going to win his sixth race of the season? Is this going to give him nearly the world title with one round to go? Rossi leads the way, Elias is there, Rossi under the ferry, are absolutely side by side. They come over the start finish line now. Who is going to win the race? And Tony Elias wins! Tony Elias has won the race. Oh my golly! Valentino Rossi in second place, Kenny Roberts third, and Colin Edwards in fourth place. What a performance by 23-year-old Tony Elias from Baeza in Spain. Can you believe it? He has won the Grand Prix of Portugal. It has been a wretched, wretched day for Honda.
and